It seemed like a film script, but even more incredible. But I had known Robert for years and I didn't think he was capable of making light of something like this. There were two fundamental aspects. Firstly, the disappearance of the plot. Secondly, Damian, he's committed to the psychiatric center and his mysterious death.
Todo comenzó el 16 de diciembre del año 2004. Martin comenzó a trabajar en la traducción de los textos y en la adaptación técnica de los planos de organización parcelaria de los terrenos de la futura exposición internacional. Como él decía, un trabajo más, salvo que algo que ni siquiera podía reconocer, le provocaba una extraña sensación de déjà vu.
Yes, it was odd, very odd. When I began working on those plans, I was aware of something. I don't know what it was. Something that was making me uneasy, or rather, something that rang a bell. At the time, I wasn't actually uneasy, not then.
Martin nació en Saffron Walden. Muy cerca, en Southend-on-Sea, reside su familia. Y hasta hace unos meses, uno de los mejores amigos de su infancia, Robert Lynch.
We hadn't seen each other for some time. His mother had died 2 weeks previously. After dinner, Robert suggested we go into the library where we'd be more comfortable. And there it was, right before me. That unusual shape. That's what I'd seen. It was like finding the gateway to spiritual peace.
La puerta de la tranquilidad, de Martin, presidía la biblioteca de Robert. Era un cuadro de su madre, un extraño cuadro, que parecía dibujar una forma muy especial, la del meandro de ranillas, el lugar donde se iba a situar la exposición internacional. Trazaba perfectamente su silueta, con una sombra central.
Well, of course, I was puzzled at first. At any rate, he soon cleared it up for me. It was a painting by his mother.
La madre de Robert, la doctora Mary Lynch, fue una de las primeras geógrafas especializadas en planificación territorial y paisajística de los sistemas fluviales de llanura. Una especialidad que en 1958 le llevó a realizar su tesis doctoral a una pequeña ciudad que aún contaba con uno de los últimos meandros vírgenes naturales de toda Europa, Zaragoza.
In 1958, Mary Lynch, a brilliant geographer who had recently graduated from Cambridge, obtained a research fellowship to write her doctoral thesis on alluvial plain river systems. Zaragoza, on the banks of the River Ebro, was a small city that back then had one of the most natural fluvial environments in Europe. In fact, it was naturally protected by the exploitation of traditional waters and plots that had been passed on from generation to generation over the years, a perfect location for her research.
I mentioned to Robert that for a moment the outline in the picture reminded me of the shape I'd seen on the development plan for the Ranillas Meander in Zaragoza that I was translating. And he said that his mother had done her thesis on something like that. And there, among the books that Robert had kept from his mother's library, the Ranillas Meander, a unique environment. I said to him, wow, what a coincidence. I asked him if he knew that this was in Zaragoza. But of course, all this had been before Robert was born. I thought, so it wasn't surprising that this distinctive shape acted as an inspiration for an abstract painting. But, well, it was a bit weird. Anyway, that was what had given rise to my feelings of déjà vu. It was like finding the gateway to spiritual peace. And that took a load off my mind.
Pero Martin cometió un movimiento que nadie, absolutamente nadie, había previsto. Antes de irse, le pidió a su amigo Robert la tesis de su madre. en parte por curiosidad, en parte por aquel extraño cuadro.
Well, I phoned Robert a few days later. We were laughing and chatting about our evening together, and I didn't mention it again, at least for a few days. A few long days.
El primero de esos largos días, Martin cometió otro error. O mejor dicho, provocó otra fatal casualidad.
So I thought I might superimpose a transparency over a current plan. I don't know, to see whether anything had changed on the river or something, just out of curiosity. And that was how it all started.
Lo que Martin descubrió fue en realidad la inquietante sombra de su puerta de la tranquilidad. Pero lo que más le desconcertó fue su ausencia. No había ninguna duda. Algo, situado en el centro, en el corazón mismo del recinto de la Expo, había desaparecido. Y era aquella sombra, la parcela 28.
Of course, that really puzzled me. It's unusual for something to physically disappear from the map. I mean, as if the adjoining plots had engulfed it so symmetrically, so supersymmetrically, that it seemed as if it had never existed.
Martin, movido por el sorprendente descubrimiento, decidió de inmediato dar un vistazo a la documentación escrita de la tesis de la doctora Lynch. Y allí encontró unas fotografías antiguas y unos sobres con cartas manuscritas. Y en realidad, este fue el auténtico principio. Porque las cartas y fotografías que Martin encontró relataban dos historias. Una historia de amor y otra de muerte.